When setting up force diagrams for dynamics problems, it's really common for students to just assume that the normal force is always mg, but there are a lot of cases where this can really get you into trouble. So in this video, we're doing a quick survey of 5 cases where the normal force is not mg, and we include the basic setup of how you calculate the normal force in all these cases. So in our first 2 examples, we have an external force pushing on a block, but the force pushes at an angle. In the first case, that force has a downward component. And this is actually what causes the normal force to not be equal to the weight. So let's complete the force diagram with the weight and normal force vectors. And then we apply Newton's second law to the y direction here. So in the y direction, the acceleration is going to be 0 because the block is constrained to the floor. And this means the vertical forces must balance. In other words, the net force is 0 in the y direction. So our forces must balance, and we look at all the upward forces, that's just n, the normal force. That has to be equal to the sum of all the downward forces, and of course we have big mg in there, but we also have that downward component of the applied force. So we end up with a normal force of mg plus f sine theta, and that's greater than the weight. We can view this intuitively by just saying the normal force will always push with the right magnitude to keep the block constrained to the floor. And since we're pushing the block down, the normal force has to counteract that by pushing up a little harder. In our second example, we have kind of the reverse case where the external force has an upward component instead. And again, we expect that the normal force is changed by the fact that we're tampering with the perpendicular direction. So we complete the force diagram. And this time when we balance the forces perpendicular to the surface, we find that n plus f sine theta, since that component of the force points upward, that has to be equal to the weight mg. This means our normal force is given by mg minus f sine theta. So here's a case where the normal force ends up being less than the weight of the object. Intuitively, we say that our upward force is helping the normal force to support this object against the force of gravity. So the normal force doesn't have to push as hard to support the block. Note that if f sine theta is actually bigger than mg, that changes the physics entirely because the net force is upward and the block will fly off the floor. Our little equation for normal force would give us a negative answer, but that's impossible because the floor can't pull the block down. In the next example, we have a block on an incline, and again, we want to compute the normal force. So gravity is pulling straight down as usual. And we do the usual force decomposition, and I'll post a link at the top to where this was first derived. And we see that one component of the weight points down the ramp, and the other points perpendicular and into the ramp. So there's the normal force pushing perpendicular to the surface, as normal forces always do. And now we ask, what does the normal force have to do in order to keep this object constrained to the surface? If the object slides on the surface, it means the perpendicular forces must balance. So we can say that n is equal to mg cosine theta. Now, because the cosine of theta is less than 1, this is another case where the normal force is less than mg. In our final 2 examples, we have a block sitting on an accelerating elevator. In the first case, the elevator is accelerating upward, and so we get our forces into the diagram. And this time, we aren't trying to balance our perpendicular forces because we actually have an acceleration in that direction. When we apply Newton's second law, we'll just start from the beginning and write F net equals ma. And we're looking at the y direction here, so we can say that is a y component equation. And the net force on this block is going to be an n pointing in the positive direction, and then minus mg, because that points in the negative direction, and this is going to be equal to the mass of the block m times this observed acceleration of a going upward. Well, this means the normal force is going to be mg plus ma. And because a is positive, this means the normal force is greater than mg. Note that in the force diagram, I already drew n larger than mg because I knew our block needed a net upward force in order to accelerate upward. Finally, our last example is kind of the reverse of the first, where the elevator is accelerating downward. This can mean the elevator is either moving upward and slowing down, or moving downward and speeding up. But all that matters for the physics of the problem is that the acceleration points downward. So there's our force diagram, and again, we apply Newton's second law. And we'll keep using upward as the positive direction, and we actually just get all the same stuff here. I have n pointing up, mg pointing down, and this is going to be equal to the mass of this object, big M, times the acceleration, a. So we arrive at the same result, n is equal to mg plus ma, but the difference here is that our a is a negative number because we're using a coordinate system where upward is positive. So this ma term is actually negative, and that means the normal force is going to be less than the weight. And notice that I drew n as a shorter vector than mg from the beginning because I knew we needed a net downward force on this block to give us a downward acceleration. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.